Hi, welcome in. What can I help you with? Something in particular you're looking for? Yes, now is such the perfect time to get started on some New Year planning. Yeah, I just got done setting up my journal. You're looking to pick out a new bullet journal. Excellent. Well, we just got a brand new shipment in and haven't really unpacked everything quite yet, so you get the pick of the litter, as they say. Are there any, let's say, particular colors that you're interested in? Kind of like earth tones. So thinking like maybe greens and browns, those sorts of colors, different shades. Are you looking for more of like very bright earth tone colors, or kind of like on the more muted side, not really bright? Okay, I'll give you some different options. If you don't mind, I'm going to sort of sort through these and pick some out for you, and we can go through that. Okay? Alright. Let's do that. We have here earth tones. I think I might have another box, so let me double check if there's any options there. I didn't see any. I went actually to the back room, and I didn't see anything back there. So it's like we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different options we could take a look at. Different brands, all 5 of them. you can see, if we're just looking at them from the outside in comparison with one another, we're seeing some slight differences in size and thickness, as well as physical size. Some of these companies kind of, I would say, have a little bit of a different interpretation of the A5 size, which is the typical bullet journal size. And this difference thickness can be accounted to several different factors, number of pages being a big one, but also the thickness of the actual paper. So, and this Vivid Scribbles one comes in a nice box. Is cute, isn't it? Maybe it can give you some different doodle ideas. Packaged really, really lovely, I must say. And get some nice goodies with it, some stickers. As you can see, this is definitely the thickest one of all of the options that we're going to look at. We can take a look at the Vivid Scribbles one first. What do you think? And then we'll just Are these colors okay? Kind of in that earth tones color scheme you're imagining. Because this one is definitely more of like a moss green. Has the flower on there. This one's definitely a little more minty. Still okay. Not an earth design, but the moon and stars, I think, are very pretty. Okay. This one's definitely more like a rich brown. It's got a nice leather texture to it as well. This one's okay. One of my favorite designs. A bear. Really nice earth tone brown. Yep. Okay. Finally, definitely the brightest colored one. Kind of like a grass green. One we have here is the paper H dotted notebook bullet journal, of course. Kind of a very thin profile, I would say. The same colors to drop. We could see on here they've given us some information about the actual notebook. 5.7 by 8 inches. Design, 160 pages, 100 GSM paper, place right here you could write your name, and it starts right out with bulleted pages. These bullets are very, very light, almost indiscernible.
Spine, as well as one for the front cover and maybe back cover. One of my favorites, the Dingbats bullet journal, A5 plus, again the 100 GSM paper, and this is more of a cream color. Vegan leather. This has
These pages are also unnumbered. Just a single black bookmark. Let's check the back. Get a little advertisement here. Shows you some of the other colored options that they have in here, as well as animals, animal designs, some of the different collections. This one is from the the ThinkPads Bear A5 Plus bullet journal with the beautiful bear on the cover. I love bears so much. Next we have the minimalist art. Did not feature numbered pages, so that's something to definitely consider when you're buying your journal. Everyone definitely has their own preference. Personally, as I was saying, everyone has their preference, whether they prefer the numbered or the non-numbered pages. But personally, I definitely prefer numbered pages because I get a little bit particular about the numbers looking perfect. Just a little bit of a small little. To consider if you yourself like to experiment and use maybe some watercolors on your journal. So this front says minimalism art. 2009, San Francisco. Very subtle gold print. Again, the nice full leather cover. Place for your name and your address. With an index page content. Two index pages. Okay. Here we can start to see the bulleted pages. And I would definitely say that the bullet so far are the darkest that I've seen so far. Here we have two bookmarks, one in a black color and one in a brown color. See where the binder is hiding. Black color. This journal has quite a bit tight binding, I feel. Under pocket at the back, which is empty. The minimalism art one. Next we have this mint green, Yup and Tom, A5. This one has much more thick pages, 160 GSM. Definitely well suited if you like to experiment with different art. Watercolors, thicker pens, thicker art. Right away, you can notice that the texture of this journal is quite different than all of the full leather ones back here. So, very matte, almost stone-like texture. Very interesting. You can see the beautiful moon and stars on the front. really shy. Something to keep in mind. Comes with a very helpful grid guide. Love those. Typically you can make your own in your journal, but it's very helpful to have this little handy one to just pop in the pocket at the back. Here's our front page. Start of the bullet journals, bullet pages. I'd say the darkness of the dots is the same as the minimalism art, quite dark and quite noticeable. You also can see that they have a special cross in the center of the page, as well as dashes marking the middle of the top, the middle of the sides as well. That's a personal preference if you like that or if you don't like that. That's something to keep in mind. Bookmarks. The pages are definitely quite thick. It's going to fall off. Pages are very thick. It's definitely going to be good for some more exciting. At the back, which is empty, so we can see if that will slide in without bending it. It will not, so you have to bend the grid. Stars journal. Okay, and last but not least, you could check the Vivid Scribbles journal. The same. I quite like the fabric kind of cover on this. It looks very nice. It also comes with a pen loop here in this green color. Okay. golden cover. Definitely shines nicely in the light. We pull to the first page and we see really pleasant green colors. This front page, the place to write your name. I'm sure you could write this in a white gel pen. It would look really nice. An index and key page. And here we start with the bulleted pages. This one is also 160 GSM. The pages are all numbered. The bullets are light colored, but the size of the bullets is rather large, so they're not as subtle, but they are light colored. The paper is thick. Again, for those, if you want to, maybe play with some watercolors, you'll very easily be able to do that with this bullet journal. Comes with three satin bookmarks. Three satin bookmarks here. The only downside is that they are all the same color, so you won't be able to very quickly flip to the page that you're looking for. This nice green color again with the pocket. Nothing in the pocket at the back. These are your options. Dark bullets in the up and down and middle is a lot. Thicker paper in the up and down and vivid scribbles. Minimalism art in between the dingbats and the paper age. The paper age is the smallest journal with the lightest, most subtle bullets. Dingbat and paper age don't have page numbers. Vivid scribbles has very large bullets, and Yup and Dum has kind of a strange cover and the strange cross and division lines on each page. So what do you think? You're thinking the paper age. That's an excellent choice. I do quite like the design of the bullets being smaller and lighter than all of the other options, honestly. I do quite like the dingbats for the bear in the front. times your paper age, it will be $5. There you go. You would like to see a little bit of inspiration? Sure. I can show you what I've done so far for my journal. This is the classic Luchterm 1917 bullet journal. And I decided with a simple design this year. Large 2023 letters. Little sprig of some dried florals. Future lock. Right now I only have birthdays added into here. This is my goals page. This is based on Jocko Willink's 6 categories of self-improvement. First week, which we are now in, and you can get started on yours now. Okay. It was a pleasure doing business with you, and good luck in 2023. I hope you have a wonderful year, and just have a very successful, healthy, and wonderful year with lots of love and joy and positivity and success in your life. So I'm here with you guys.